What is going on, YouTube? SciGuy29 coming at you from beautiful Cardboard Pub. It's episode 154 of Crafts and Cards. I'm glad you're joining me tonight. Another new beer, brewery that I have had on the show before. Kind of an offshoot of a beer. Got a nice stack of Hall of Famers here. Nothing exciting, but they are all Hall of Famers, so we'll go from there. Now, I'm don't have my usual glass. I've got the Oakshire glass. Notice it's Eugene, Oregon. And when I went out, 9 years ago now, my niece got married out in Oregon, and great beer scene, fantastic beer no matter where we went. We were there for 8 days, and I hit a bunch of breweries, like 14 breweries. You may recognize that symbol, and that's the dead guy symbol from Rogue Brewing, not Oakshire, but this is an Oregon beer coming from Newport, Oregon. And I would highly recommend, if you ever get to go, drive down the coast. Rogue's there. Stop at Newport. Just a fun little town. Some really nice, inexpensive places to stay right on the ocean. So good. But this is not typical dead guy. This is a dead guy pale ale. And you can see it says tropical malt, citrus, bitter, pine. Dead Guy Pale Ale features Eldorado and Sabro hops to create a burst of tangerine and peach notes in a beer fit to raise the dead. So it's a 5.5 ABV, 35 IBUs. And they've got a new thing on here. I need to figure out what that is, but a new number and letters grouping, so maybe I'll do a little research and maybe we can both learn something new. But we'll get this poured up. Very light colored, as you would imagine. Much lighter than my last beer last week, or 2 weeks ago, I guess. So here it is. There's that good looking can. We'll put it in the back. A little light test. Yep, there it is. Get the Miller. Ooh, look at that. But definitely get that little fruity notes there when you sniff. Cheers. Good stuff. Definitely get some of that tangerine peachy aftertaste. So, gonna take another drink of that. It's pretty good. So, I was going through a binder and came across, I don't know, 8 or 9 pages that had cards from the year 2000 and a variety of brands. I think I've got 3 different, from 3 different sets. We've got some 2000 Upper Deck Yankee Legends. We've got some, what were these? Fleer Greats of the Game, and then some just Fleer, what were the Tradition, I think is what those were. So not sure we'll get through all these tonight, but we're going to go through them anyway. Shout out to all my Yankee brothers, Lou Rock, TJ, you guys know who you are, you Yankee goobers. Just kidding, I love you guys. Start off with this Whitey Ford. This is a base card from the set of the Upper Deck Yankees Legends. Now, I can't remember if they did a Giants version of this or if that was... I've got those, some of those back there, too. This is the Magic Numbers card of Casey Stengel. Mixed that up already. Here we have a Wade Boggs, shout out to John, Wade Boggs fan. Popping some champagne. Here we have a guy that it pains me to see in Yankee uniform, Dave Winfield. Mr. October himself, Reggie. Classic swing pose. couple of Joe Torres. And another. Here we have magic numbers for catcher, but this is Bill Dickey, not Yogi. You can see how they have the names and the magic numbers there. I'm guessing those are the ones that are retired. I didn't look into it a whole lot. Here's the Bill Dickey base card. This is from the championship years, I guess. Part of it. Here's Yogi in a base. And I like this because they had full stats on the back, which is kind of nice. We have a Lefty Gomez, championship years. Here's the Babe. And everybody's classic pose for the Babe Ruth card. Babe Ruth in general, just an image. Here we have a magic number of Scooter, Phil Rizzuto. And, you know, what would it be without Mickey? And I only bought, oh man, I'm going to guess 7 or 8 packs because they were expensive. They were like $4 or $5 a piece. And I was, of course, chasing the autographs that came in those packs. Those I actually bought down in Des Moines at Iowa Cubs Fan Fest. So that's where I had those, or got those. Did not hit any of the autos. This next grouping, the greats of the game, I purchased these uptown for the same exact reason. I was hunting autographs. But I, just something about these cards I like. They're basic, but just kind of a classic look. Here's Bruce Sutter with the Braves. We have Alan Trammell. And these again have full stats, little bio, little write-up. We have Jim Palmer. Thinking about sending that off to TTM action. And hope that he'd sign about right there on his leg, right above his name. Andre Dawson in the Expos uniform, so I love that even more. We have the Wizard, Ozzie Smith. Tom Seaver. Bob Lemon. Shout out to my Indian boys. Scott, Reindeer Studios. Somebody else. I can't think who it is, though. Gaylord Perry as a Giant. It's kind of funny, some of these guys that, you know, you look at the back. How many different teams did Gaylord Perry play for? A lot. So, we have Lou Brock, Willie McCovey, Jim Cott. I was literally going to send this off TTM. It's got a bad corner, you can see it. These aren't perfect by any means. But then he elected the Hall of Fame and jacked his prices. So I've only sent him... Send them to 65 tops. I wanted more of an actual playing days. We have Juan Marichal. Another one I've thought about sending off. We have Eddie Murray. Or excuse me, Eddie Matthews. Jesus. Get that right, man. Slightly different guys. We have Al Kaline. Enos Slaughter. And he, I didn't realize he bounced around as much as he did at the end of his career. We have Whitey Ford. And then one of my favorite images in the set, Roy Campanella. Shout out to Snoop, 12922. And last, we'll go through them quick. I'll get another drink quick. These are from Fleer Tradition, 2000 as well. These actually came in a box my wife bought me for my birthday. We used to have a five and dime type of store called Pomida. It's now no longer around. Got bought out by whoever, and then they've been bought out since. None of those stores exist around here anymore. But they used to have boxes on for like weight clearance. Like, I bought a box of, it's like $10 for a box of 89 tops. They'd have stuff like, well, she got me this Fleer Tradition box. So here we have the award winners with Pedro. That just got loud. Maybe it's been that way the whole time. This is Roberto Alomar. Kind of that 53 tops look. Here's a Robin Yount 3000 Club. Die cut. Cal Ripken. We have a Dividends of Scott Rowland. Here's his base card. And we'll wrap it up with the kid, miscut, Ken Griffey Jr. So hope all is well. Hope the weather's great. The cards are flowing. And life's good. So until next time, from the Cardboard Pub, remember, collect what you love. Love what you collect. Cheers.